Hello, my name is Greg McGloskin, the Chief Currency Analyst for FXDD, and this is a trade idea for SFO. I remind everybody that trading Forex is risky. Traders can lose all or part of their trading capital. Traders should only use risk capital that they are prepared to lose. This trade idea is meant for educational purposes only. None of the statements of opinions or recommendations are to be considered as constituting a track record. Past performance is no indication of future results. Trading Forex can be quite difficult. However, there are times when there are what I call low-hanging fruit trades that are ripe for the picking. It does not take much. It just takes seeing the bias, risking a little, and seeing what happens. Sometimes a trade is sweet. The market trends in the direction of your bias. Other times the trade sours, and with proper stop-loss management, you can discard it quickly with minimal damage. Let me show you what I mean. This is a chart of the euro versus US dollar. It's a 5-minute chart. I want you to focus on this ceiling level at the 135.37 level. There's a number of times that the market tests this ceiling. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different times the market comes up to that 37 level and bangs against the ceiling. Each of the time, there's not enough momentum to push it through. Is this significant? You bet. Logic says if buyers cannot push the price higher, the price should move lower. In this example, there are some other clues for executing a trade. Let's take a look at the low to high trading range. This low right here, it comes in at 134.94. Our high over this period comes in at 135.37. This 11-hour period has a range of only 43 pips. To put things in perspective, the narrowest range for a day in 2011 has been 53 pips. Only 2 times it was less than 67 pips, and only 10 times it was less than 84 pips. So there is a great chance that the range will be extended either to the upside or to the downside. Another clue comes from our moving averages. The green line represents our 200 bar moving average, and the blue line represents our 100 bar moving average. When the two moving averages are moving sideways like they are in this example, is indicative of a non-trending market. When the market's non-trend, I like to look for a trend away. In this case, the ceiling is suggesting to the downside. It's simply too obvious to ignore. It is the equivalent of the low-hanging fruit that is worthy of picking. Selling against a level is the logical trade. What's the risk? Well, if a trader would sell against this 37 level, what I would suggest is a stop loss somewhere around the 42 level. So assume our trader sold on the break of the 100 bar moving average, let's say at the 135.29 level. Sell at 29, risk 42, that's 13 pips of risk. Not much for foreign exchange trading. In this example, let's see what happened. As you might expect, we found initial support against the 100 bar moving average, but then moved below that level. The test of the moving average at this point forced the market further to the downside, where we found support against, well, the low for the day. The corrective move up here to the 100 and 200 bar moving average is significant. The market has a decision to make at this point. Does it want to move higher, or does it want to move lower? Traders who are short from this level up here should remain in the trade. Why? Because the integrity of the trade remains. We still have a low range for the day. We're expecting a range extension. And our moving averages are starting to show some signs of downward bias. Our 100 bar moving average is kinking to the downside, and so is our 200. It's already moving to the downside. So this suggests that the bias is to the downside. And as you can see, the market did in fact move sharply in that direction. Our move to the downside stopped at the 134.38 level. We then started to consolidate in an up and down fashion here. When the market failed on the break of the 38 level to the downside and moved back within our consolidation range here, it's probably time to exit that trade. Traders who either exit at this high consolidation range would enjoy a gain of around 64 pips. Traders who exited near the low of this consolidation range would enjoy a gain of 91 pips. So for a risk of 13 pips up here, traders have the opportunity to earn a multiple of that risk. Finding the low-hanging fruit can lead to a sweet trade. Of course, some trades, no matter how tempting, can sour and your stop-loss level can be triggered and a loss realized. However, others may lead to a nice trend-like gain. So be on the lookout and enjoy the fruits of your relatively easy labor. My name is Greg Michaloski, and this is a trade idea for SFO.